Superstorm Sandy, one of the strongest storms ever to batter the United States, claims at least 16 lives and knocks out power to an estimated 7 million people on the U.S. East Coast. Well, here in India, Cyclone Neelam is advancing towards Tamil Nadu, expected to make landfall tomorrow. We'll get you all the latest from New York and Chennai and have a special panel to discuss just how prepared are our cities. But that's coming up later on the show tonight. But first, Narendra Modi taking pot shots at Shashi Tharoor's personal life, saying his wife Sunanda Pushkar was once his 50 crore rupee girlfriend. Shashi Tharoor responds to those remarks, says his wife is worth far more than 50 crores, she is priceless. But we're asking tonight, has the language of sexism now taken political campaigning to an all new low? That's coming up in a moment from now. But first, a look at the other news stories. Will there be a reshuffle in the Congress next, marking Rahul Gandhi the second in command, making Rahul Gandhi the second in command? Sources say the announcement is likely on Friday when the Congress will hold a mega rally in Delhi. 13 people are questioned as the Income Tax Department starts a pan-India inquiry into Gadkari's investor companies. Their sources say prima facie these do look like shell companies. You won't have to shell out less for your loans. The RBI doesn't cut interest rates. The finance minister expresses his deep disappointment. A chartered accountant who'd created a mid-air hijack scare in 2009 is sentenced to life in jail. Is that a little too extreme? But first, our big story tonight. In the verbal dueling that he prefers, Narendra Modi might just have met his match. Hours after he made an astonishingly personal attack on new central minister Shashi Tharoor, calling his wife a 50 crore girlfriend at an election rally in Himachal Pradesh, he had his answer from Mr. Tharoor. But this isn't just about a husband standing up for a wife. There's growing outrage over Narendra Modi's remark and whether with it, political discourse has hit an all new low.
कांग्रेस के एक मंत्री थे, पार्लियामेंट में पहले वो मिनिस्टर हुआ करते थे, उन पर आरोप लगे पैसों की धांधली के, क्रिकेट के ढीकने फलाने। उन्होंने संसद में उठ करके खड़े होकर के कहा था कि जिस महिला ने मेरे खाते में पचास करोड़ जमा हुए हैं, वो 50 करोड़ रुपए से मेरा कोई लेना देना नहीं है, संसद में कहा था। और महीने भर के अंदर अंदर उनकी शादी की पत्रिकाएं सब दूर घूमने लगी। भाइयों बहनों, बता दीजिए, इस देश में कभी किसी ने 50 करोड़ की गर्लफ्रेंड देखी है?
Well, I've already said it on Twitter. I've replied saying that this imaginary 50 crores that he went on about, there's not even 50 paise involved and gained for anyone associated with that effort. In any case, since he was silly enough to attack my wife in the process, I said that, she's worth far more than the 50 crores, the imaginary 50 crores he's talking about. She's priceless to me. But I added, you have to be able to love someone to understand that.
All right, joining us to discuss this tonight, Sahil Seth, Managing Partner, Councillage. We also have Dilip Cherian, Shazia Ilmi, Member of India Against Corruption, and JVL Narasimha Rao, Member of the BJP's National Electoral Reforms Committee. Sahil, political campaigning hitting an all-new low, dragging in somebody, his wife, referring to him as his girlfriend. What are we hearing here, really?
I think I'm not too surprised. I'm saddened by the fact that someone who is contending for prime ministership or supposedly contending for prime ministership should not behave prime ministerial. I think the tragedy, Ankita, is public discourse by and large has hit a new low. For all the good work that India Against Corruption may be doing, for Arvind Kejriwal to at times use the kind of language he uses is not fair. I think the language that is used in both the upper and the lower houses is not on. Our leaders have become gutter snipes. And they believe that by attacking people personally, that by using the kind of language that is not only shameful, it is unforgivable. Apart from everything else, the sexism, the underlying sexism is intolerable. What kind of a country are we becoming? I mean, this is the party that boasted of statesmen like Vajpayee. But it would be unfair only to blame Modi. because the Congress does it with equal abundance at times. You know, there have been times when Modi's been called mass murderer. I mean, unless the man is convicted, you don't use terminology such as this. So the reality, Ankita, is not about Narendra Modi or, you know, I mean, I personally feel that it is unforgivable what was said about Sunanda. It shouldn't be said of any woman, of forget whether she is Shashi Tharoor's wife or not. It is intolerable and reprehensible for any woman to be called this in a public meeting. The tragedy is, in India, we have no issues left. These are the people who should be talking about issues. They should be talking about power. They should be talking about water. They should be talking about food, about law and order, about safety. What are we doing? We're taking pot shots at individuals.
Let me take that to the BJP. Narasimha Rao, this is a man who is a potential prime ministerial candidate for this country. Has he, in a sense, scored an own goal over here? Why bring the discourse down to this level?
No, I think we are discussing this issue as if Sunanda Pushkar has become a discussion point
it's
on
not
television
about
today.
Sunanda Pushkar,
you, all of you in the media have called her his girlfriend. At the time this controversy arose, he answered many questions. He had no objection to it. Even today, I don't think Shashi Tharoor has any objection to her being called girlfriend.
I think you're missing the point here, Mr. Rao. I think you are entirely missing the point over here.
No, the issue is corruption. You're missing the real point. The issue, what he was trying to hint at, is the debasement of politics under UPA 2 and the level ministers who have been alleged on corruption, ministers who have been forced to leave the government are coming back and this government is rehabilitating.
Would the BJP like Yediyurappa's girlfriend to be talked about qua corruption when the issue is corruption? Would you like that? And Mr. Rao, I think you're a civilized human being as you are. I don't think you can actually justify the comment. And I completely agree with you. If the issue is corruption, talk about corruption.
Yes.
Don't drag a person who is not in public life into this debate, hoping to score what I call political parroting points in very facetious debating style.
Unfortunately, it is the money, the gain, the financial gain accrued to Ms. Sunanda Pushkar. So she's not being dragged into it unnecessarily. She's been given sweat equity and she's been financially benefited only for the simple reason she is friends
with Mr. Let me bring in Shazia Ilmi at this point. In India Against Corruption has taken on politicians across the political spectrum on the issue of corruption. Do you believe this debate was framed, or these comments were framed in that sort of light, or do you believe that perhaps even though the issue ought to have been raised, the way in which, the manner in which it was done was reprehensible?
Oh, absolutely. His remarks are sexist, unsavory, and to say the least, I'm hearing my own voice back. But, you know, Ankita, the point here is, even if he wanted to talk about corruption per se, he could have demystified sweat equity of 5%.
Absolutely.
He could have used better language. He's a man who uses his words carefully. And I'm amazed at the kind of language he's used. I'm shocked. What was he thinking? And also the fact of the matter is that where the track record of all the parties are concerned, the way they speak of women is reprehensible, totally, is deplorable. Whether Shri Prakash Jaiswal and now Narendra Modi, you want to talk about corruption, you talk about corruption and the different ways of saying it. But
do you believe the charge has been made over here by Sohail Seth saying India Against Corruption is equally guilty
of
bringing the discourse down to a level where it's all about personal attacks? Do you think that, you know, this is now true of the entire political discourse?
The thing you could do is apologize personally to Sunanda.
Shazi, I just want to ask you, over here we are hearing that India Against Corruption has also made very personal attacks against politicians. It's also called them names. Is the whole level of discourse now being, you know, lowered to a new abysmal low?
We have used legal facts, documents, and we said 1/3 of the parliamentarians are corrupt, and they have in their own affidavits, by their own admission, charges of corruption against them.
But go back.
So we're not
back.
Saying anything new, something that has been in the public domain.
But Ankita, go
we have
back.
Not done, we have not personally called anybody names.
But go back in
that
history.
That is not true.
Go back in history.
And if we can recall even one incident where we've attacked somebody personally or hit below the belt without any evidence whatsoever,
Shazia,
then I'll stand corrected.
No, but the thing is that this is now the language of politicians is no longer the language of leaders. It is the language of the street. You know, all of them have now perhaps because of the humble origins that they all want to claim, or because they all want to be equated with the Aam Aadmi, whatever it is, they are reflecting the language of people who should not be in positions of power, of dignity, and of trying to take society into a new space. The image of the politician is actually getting very badly bruised in this process. And whichever side you're talking, it's not about sides. It is simply a matter of recognizing that today debate has reached a point where the politician uses words which will be insulting.